Hi guys, welcome back to Math Class with Ms. Brown. Before we get started, make sure you hit the red subscribe button for more videos. Make sure you like, comment, and share this video with your family and friends. Now let's jump into today's lesson. So today we will be dividing decimals by a whole number, right? So we have 376.4 divided by 6, right? So we're going to bring our whole number up, and then we're going to take our decimal number, 376.4, and we're going to place it just like that. But just make sure before you start dividing, make sure you bring that decimal up and make sure that it is lined up. Next, before we start dividing, I'm going to take my divisor, which is the 6, and I'm going to go ahead and write my multiples of 6. And this will make sure that your process is much easier and smooth. Right, you guys will see as we go along. Okay, so I wrote my multiples of 6. So now I'm going to ask myself, how many groups of 6 can I get out of 3? The answer is none, so that's why I put 0. Then next I'm going to say, how many groups of 6 can I get out of 37? So as I can see, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, I can get 6 groups, right? So now I'm going to multiply. 6 times 6 is 36. Now I'm going to subtract, right? So have that 1. I'm going to bring my six down. Now I'll have 16. How many groups of 6 can I get out of 16? And the answer is 2, right? The answer is 2. So I'm going to say, okay, I'm going to put my 2 up there, and I'm going to multiply. 6 times 2 is 12. I'm going to go ahead and put my 12, and I'm going to go ahead and subtract. And my answer is 4. Bring down that 4. Now I'm going to say, how many groups of 6 can I get out of 44? And the answer is 7. Okay, put the 7 up there, multiply. 7 times 6 is 42. 44 minus 42. Okay, bring down the 0. So now we have, how many groups of 6 can I get out of 20? The answer was 3. Multiply 6 times 3, which is 18. And then my answer left over is 2, right? So I have no more digits up there to bring down, so I'm going to bring that 0 down. The process is going to repeat over and over and over. It is never going to stop, as you guys can see. The more we keep adding a 0 and bringing it down, that process is going to keep happening. That decimal number is going to keep going on and on forever. So we have to stop at some point. So I stop there, and I'm going to take what I have at the top, and I have 62.733, and I can use this as my final answer. I hope that this makes a lot of sense. Let's try another one. All right, so 25.6 divided by 5. I'm going to go ahead and bring my divisor up, which is 5. And then we have 25.6. I'm going to go ahead and put that in, 25.6. And then I'm going to make sure I bring my decimal up. That's very important. Make sure that they are lined up. Now I'm going to go ahead and write my multiples of 5 on the side. So I'm going to say 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. I'm going to just go ahead and write those multiples. And then the first question I'm going to ask myself is, how many groups of 5 can I get out of 2? The answer is 0. I'm going to bring the 0. 0 times 5 is 0. We don't have to do anything. And then how many groups of 5 can I get out of 25, which is 5. 5 times 5 is 25. Go ahead and subtract. Bring the 6 down. How many groups of 5 can I get out of 6, which is 1. 5 times 1 is 5. And I have 1. Bring the 0 down. How many groups of 5 can I get out of 10, which is 2. 2 times 5 is 10. 10 minus 10 is 0. It stops there because it's just 0. So my final answer is 5.12. I know that was fast, but I hope that this makes a lot of sense. Let's try another one. Okay, we have 879.6 divided by 13. As you guys can see, I wrote my multiples of 13 on the side already. So I'm going to go ahead and set my problem up, making sure that I bring my decimal up and making sure that it is lined up. So now I'm going to say, how many groups of 13 can I get out of 8? The answer is none, right? So I'm going to bring that 0 up. Now I'm going to move on. How many groups of 13 can I get out of 87? That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The answer is 6. Bring the 6 up. 13 times 6 is 78. I'm going to go ahead and subtract. I'm going to take my time and make sure that I subtract. All right, here we go. Okay. All right, now bring down this 9. How many groups of 13 could I get out of 99? So that's 6, 7. The answer is 7. I'm going to bring my 7 up. 13 minus 7, 13 times 7, I'm sorry, is 91. I'm going to go ahead and subtract, bring down the 6. How many groups of 13 could I get out of 86? All right, let's count on the side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The answer is 6. I'm going to go ahead and put the 6 up there. 13 times 6 is... All right, 78. Go ahead and subtract. There we go. Bring down that 0. All right, how many groups of 13 can I get out of 80? Okay, so at this point, I could see that the process is going to be repetitive, meaning that it's going to keep going on and on and on and on and on, right? We're going to keep bringing those zeros down. And then at some point, we have to stop, you guys, okay? So when I get a lot of digits at the top, I can just say, okay, let's stop. So now I see I have 67.66, and I could just be fine just like this with my answer, and it's going to be my final answer. I hope that this makes a lot of sense, guys. Yeah, the more you practice, the better you will become. All right, so don't get discouraged. I hope you guys enjoyed today's lesson. Don't forget to hit the red subscribe button for more videos. Like, comment, and share. Bye.